Now that we've talked a bit about how the neurons work, let's look at the organization of the vertebrate nervous system. Our nervous system has some features and patterns of organization common to all vertebrates. And that is, first, the concept of centralization. Which is the presence of a central nervous system distinct from the peripheral nervous system. And then also, cephalization, and that is the concentration of the nervous system at the head. Now, in all vertebrates, the brain and the spinal cord make up the central nervous system. The spinal cord acts as the central communication conduit between the brain and the rest of the body. And the brain is the master control center of the nervous system. The brain and the spinal cord contain the densest concentration of neurons in our body. Both the brain and the spinal cord also contain spaces filled with a liquid called cerebrospinal fluid. This cerebrospinal fluid, it protects and nourishes the cells of the central nervous system. Now the meninges are layers of connective tissue that also protect the brain and the spinal cord. Now, if you've ever heard of a disease called meningitis is an inflammation of these meninges, and it can be a especially dangerous disease because it can end up applying pressure and potentially even damaging our central nervous system. Now, the central nervous system neural tissue has two distinct areas, but what's surprising is that these differences are not due to different types of tissues. In fact, they're both even made of the same type of cells, but just different regions of the neurons. The white matter is composed primarily of the axons of the neurons. Now, many of these axons will have myelin sheaths on them, but the white matter, again, is mostly the axons of the neurons, whereas the gray matter is composed primarily of cell bodies and dendrites of the neurons. When we look at the diagram of the central nervous system, here we see an image of the brain and a cross-section of the spinal cord. We can see the areas containing the cerebrospinal fluids. There's actually a complex series of chambers within the brain with this fluid, and a pore down the center of the spinal column with that material as well. The meninges in this diagram are the outer layers, both of the brain and of the spinal cord, a layer of connective tissue that's there for protection. And then the gray matter and the white matter, we can see this most clearly in the cross-section of the spinal cord. But the brain itself also has regions which are primarily gray matter, primarily white matter. In fact, the outer wrinkly part of our brain, known as our cerebral cortex, has an outer layer of gray matter with white matter towards the middle of each of those ridges. So this is our central nervous system. The peripheral nervous system for vertebrates is divided into two components, the somatic nervous system, which controls the voluntary nerve signals both to and from our skeletal muscles, and then the autonomic nervous system, which is primarily involuntary. And in fact, the autonomic nervous system is divided into two divisions, the parasympathetic and the sympathetic. The parasympathetic division mostly is responsible for controlling the actions and behaviors relating to rest and digestion. Whereas the sympathetic division is active during our fight or flight response. So the somatic nervous system carries signals to and from our skeletal muscles, mainly in response to external stimuli. The autonomic nervous system regulates the internal environment by controlling smooth and cardiac muscles, and the organs and glands of the digestive, cardiovascular, excretory, and endocrine systems. Within the autonomic nervous system, there are two divisions, the parasympathetic division. And the sympathetic division. These two divisions are antagonists, meaning they have opposite effects on the body. We can see that each division will control several of our organs, but one will likely increase the activity of that organ or organ system, whereas the other will decrease that activity. Remember, the parasympathetic division is active during digesting and resting, so this slows our heart rate. It stimulates the stomach and pancreas and intestines. It is when our body is at rest. Comparatively, our sympathetic division is instead going to dilate our pupils, inhibit saliva production, dilate our bronchi so we can get more oxygen from the air we breathe, accelerate our heart rate, stimulate the epinephrine and norepinephrine release from the adrenal glands, really just preparing the body for intense physical activity. So the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system, these are the main divisions of the nervous system in vertebrates. In the next video, we're going to look at the structures of the brain itself. See you in the next video.